Hi there. Now, as you know, this is my first video blog on record collecting and vinyl collecting and the like, so apologies that it's taken so long for me to actually record this, and apologies that it might sound actually quite crap, so hopefully it won't, and well, here goes. Now, I've only just started actually collecting records quite recently, so I don't have as many as you guys, but in time, I hope to build up a vast collection of records. So, without further ado, let's go through them. Okay, now, the first album is an A&M record, and it's by Herb Albert. Now, as you know, A&M, Herb Albert, he helped with Jerry Moss create A&M Records. So, that's what record number one. Another record is one of my favourite bands, actually. It's Toto, and this is album number four. Sorry, this is album number two, but call number four. But I do like the artwork. It's a shame that the record got a bit damaged, but that's what happens when you get second-hand records, I suppose. And like I said, apart from the song Africa, it's got Good For You, It's A Feeling, Love Is In The Night, I Won't Hold You Back, that kind of thing. So there's that one. That one's a little bit better anyway, than back anyway. And because I'm a great fan of jazz music, I've got a couple of jazz records in here, including this one from the late great Kenny Ball with his biggest hit, Midnight in Moscow. And this also has March of the Siamese Children, which if you've seen The King and I, you'll know that that's from there, and the Beatles classic When I'm 64. And here comes the cheesy albums. Well, one of them. I'll show you the other two in a minute. This one is called Diana Ross, Join the Temptation, and the Supremes. I actually quite like the artwork on that one. Obviously it's got the record's coming in. You can tell the second hand and the old condition keeps popping out. But anyway, this has got Ain't No Mountain High Enough, I Second That Emotion, I'm Gonna Make You Love Me. It's probably the Supremes and the Temptations' biggest hit. And moving on. Again. Now this, I've always been a fan of James Taylor's, but I've never actually got any of his vinyl, so this one is called Sweet Baby, Sweet Baby James, and has Carole King featured on piano there, so good album that one. I can't wait to listen to that one. Next one, we have Rod Stewart. Now, although I don't really actually like much of Rod Stewart's material, I do have to say that Every Picture Tells a Story is one of my favourite songs of the 70s, but that's a bit of a general big thing to say really, because, well, I love anything really, so, but anyway, this is Every Picture Tells a Story by Rod Stewart. I'll tell you about more of my favourite stuff as the time progresses. Okay, moving on, Simple Mind, great band. And this one is Sparkle in the Rain, which has got quite a few things, but I haven't shown you a record of some of these records, have I? But actually, they're pretty boring. Doesn't that sound really English? Pretty boring. Anyway, they're not that exciting. But at least I can actually read that without wearing glasses. Okay. Another one of my all-time favourite bands is this record down here. Now this is actually from the 60s, Best of the Beach Boys, with obviously biggest hits I Get Around, God Only Knows, 7 USA, Fun Fun Fun, etc, etc, so I'm looking forward to hearing that one too. Okay, now, a couple more, and like I said, as I like jazz music, I've got quite a few more to show you, including this one, a great pairing. Ella Fitzgerald. No, I'm waiting for some Ella Fitzgerald vinyls actually, so when they come I'll be able to show you those. But this one is Bing and Louis Armstrong. No guesses which one's which. And this one has been arranged and conducted by Billy May. And on the back, a huge information list about what they've been up to. But I won't bore you with it, but it's quite a few songs I've not actually heard of before, so looking forward to hearing that one. Now this one I would probably, the next one, whatever. You can tell this is my first video blog because I don't make any sense whatsoever. Anyway, This is one from celebrating 10 years of James Bond. As you know, it's 50 years this year. So, inside, the only thing is the insert has actually come out, but you can see that from Dr. No, Goldfinger, Thunderball, You Only Live Twice, Her Majesty's Secret Service with Diana Rigg in it. One of the best films, in fact. Probably the best of the early years, but I'll let you decide which one's your favourite. Then Diamonds Are Forever, and once again, Louis Armstrong with his hit We Have All the Time in the World. And this one's a two record set, so I'm looking forward to seeing that one. And now, I did say that there are... got no room anywhere, so put them over there. I did say that I only had one cheesy collection. Well, I did actually lie. I've actually got three today to show you. Now, you're probably hearing in the background, it's not actually on record because I've put it on CD, but I've got it on CD, sorry. This one. Any ideas? Well, if I show you the back, it's a Carpenter's A Kind of Hush. Oops, knocked myself out with it. It's a kind of... Oh dear. Yeah, Kind of Hush album from 1976. One of the... In fact, this is probably my favourite album from the Carpenter's, so... I'm glad I got that one. Put that in the back before I lose it. As you probably can guess, I lose things or forget things. Hence why I forgot to do this blog, but we got there in the end. And the final one for this video blog is this. Another Carpenter's one and A Song For You. And once again, it's a bit of a rubbishy back, but if I look straight inside, put that down. I do like the illustrations that are on here, particularly that one. So, put that one back. Okay, so that's probably it. Well, that is it, in fact, for now. I hope you've enjoyed listening to my babblings on about records. I will keep you posted as and when I get some more. And I will apologise once again that it has taken me so long to actually get them to you live, as it were. So thanks for listening, and I'll see you soon.